Hello everyone, I am Mukesh Tiwari. Welcome everybody in this video of Smart Exam Academy. This is the video on the climate of India, the second chapter of your geography book class 10. In this video we will have a small discussion with the difference between the weather and the climate, the rainfall, wind system in the summer and the winter, the different factors which affect the climate of India. And we will also discuss about the seasons and its various features. So let's begin. So welcome back in this video of the climate of India. This is the second chapter of the ICSE board class 10. So let's begin. Indian climate is called the monsoon type climate. Before we start the discussion of the climate of India, it is necessary to understand the difference between the weather and the climate. So if we differentiate between the weather and the climate, we can tell that the weather is a day-to-day changing matter, and the climate means the atmospheric condition of a larger area for a long period of time. So we can also tell that the climate is a broader concept and the weather is a smaller concept. Climate means the atmospheric condition for a large area for a long period of time. It can be called a more than 30 years, even more than 30 years. But the climate is a day-to-day changing matter. In some cases, it may differ on hourly basis. It may also be differ on the hourly basis. So the weather is a day-to-day or in some cases hourly basis changing atmospheric condition of a small area. And the climate is the atmospheric condition of a large area for a long period of time. So I hope that you are able to understand the difference between the weather and the climate. So now let's move ahead. You can write down the main points of the difference between the weather and the climate. Let's move. Monsoon. If we talk about monsoon, as I have already said just now, Indian climate is called the monsoon type climate. So monsoon is an Arabic word which means season. Now let's understand about the factors which affect the climate of India. As we already know that Indian climate is a monsoon type climate, but the latitude of India affect the climate of India into various aspects. If we talk about the latitude, the largest latitude of the globe, if we talk about the globe, the picture may not be correct, I think. If we talk about the globe, this is the 0 degree latitude. It means the equator. So as we move away from the equator, either in the northern side or in the southern side, the temperature will decrease. As we everyone know that India receives the largest heat at the equator. It is called the 0 degree latitude. The 0 degree latitude is called the equator of India. At the top of the equator in the northern side, it is called the Tropic of Cancer. Tropic of Cancer, which is located at 23 and half degree north. So India is located at the Tropic of Cancer. The Tropic of Cancer crosses India at the middle and divide India into two parts. The southern part is called the ट्रॉपिकल क्लाइमेट इज कॉल्ड द ट्रॉपिकल एरिया एंड द नॉर्दर्न पार्ट ऑफ द ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द सब ट्रॉपिकल एरिया सब ट्रॉपिकल रीजन. So as we move away from the equator, either in the northern or in the southern side, the temperature decreases. So because the southern part is more close to the equator, it receives the heat. It receives more heat than the northern part of the Tropic of Cancer. So if a place is closer to the equator, it will receive more heat. So the latitude of India also affect the climate of our country. Regarding the Tropic of Cancer, I hope that everybody know this, that this Tropic of Cancer is located at 23.5 degrees north, and it crosses the eight different states. That means the Gujarat, the Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Tripura, Mizoram, including all these countries, the Tropic of Cancer crosses the 8 states. So the latitude, the lower the latitude, the hotter the area is. So I hope that everybody has understood the role of latitude in determining the climate of our country. Let's move. Altitude means the height from the sea level. We regard sea level to understand the height of the any place, because the level of the sea remains same in all the places. The sea level always remains the same. So the altitude, it means as we go up, as we increase in the height, the temperature will decrease. A question also arises, why Jaipur is hotter, the temperature of the Jaipur always remains higher, and the temperature of Himachal Pradesh, always remains low. The Himachal Pradesh is a cold area, is located at the colder place, and Jaipur is located at the hotter place. It is because of the altitude. The temperature of Darjeeling always remains low because it is located at the higher altitude. So higher is the altitude, higher is the place, the temperature will decrease. It is said that 165 meter up, if you go 165 meter up, 1 degree centigrade temperature will decrease. The temperature will decrease by 1 degree centigrade. It is also called the lapse rate. Lapse rate is a common term in the troposphere. Lapse rate. So if anybody asks you what is the meaning of lapse rate, lapse rate means decrease in the temperature of any place. If anybody go 165 meter up, 1 degree temperature will decrease. It is called the lapse rate. So because of the lapse rate, the temperature of any place decreases, and as we move towards the hilly area, the temperature will decrease, and the temperature will be high at the plain area, at the Indo-Gangetic plain, the temperature will always be higher. Now Himalaya is a cause of defense for India. Himalaya is another topic. Himalaya is a cause of defense. It is another feature. So if we talk about the Himalaya, it is called, in this area, it is called the Trans-Himalaya. And if we talk about Himalaya, it is called, as everybody know, that Himalaya is divided into three parts, Himadri, Himachal, and the Shivalik. So Himalaya is a cause of defense for India, because it acts as a defense for our country, as well as it also has a great influence upon the climate of India also. How? Because if we talk about the Himalaya protects in the winter season, Himalaya protects the colder winds from Central Asia. Whatever the colder winds come, it protects our country. Otherwise, in the absence of the Himalaya, our country would be turned into ice in the winter season because of the cold winds of from the Central Asia. Cold winds from the Central Asia. So India protects and maintains the temperature of our place by stopping the cold winds from the Central Asia, as well as it also protects the monsoon from going away from India. It do not allow, because of its height, Himalaya do not allow the southwest monsoon to go towards the Tibetan plateau. It is called the Tibetan plateau. Tibetan plateau. It also has a profound influence upon maintaining the temperature of India. So it do not allow the monsoon to go towards the Tibetan plateau. That is how it also protects the monsoon to go towards the Tibetan plateau, and it also protects the cold winds from entering into India, and it also maintains the climate of our country. So Himalaya is a cause of defense, as well as it has important role in maintaining the temperature of our country. So I hope the altitude factor you have understood. Let's move. Distance from the sea. If a place is located at the seashore, near the seashore, it will be temperate. The climate of that part is a temperate climate. If we talk about Maharashtra, in Maharashtra, in West Bengal, Odisha, the temperature remains low at the time of the summer season, and the temperature remains comparatively comfortable even at the time of winter. But if we talk about Delhi, Uttar Pradesh, the area of the Delhi and Uttar Pradesh, in the area of the Delhi and Uttar Pradesh, the temperature always remains higher at the time of summer season, but at the same time, during the time of winter, the temperature remains very low compared to the other places because of the land breeze and the sea breeze. At the time of the winter, the hot air comes from the sea towards the land area, and at the time of the summer, the cold air comes from the sea area to the land area. So it maintains a temperate climate over the seashore states. So the distance from the sea also maintains the climate of our country. I hope that you are able to understand this. So areas nearer to the sea experience the maritime climate, whereas the areas away from the sea experience continental climate. So the distance from the sea also maintains the climate of our country. I hope that you have able to understand this. Let's move. The Himalaya range. So just now I have explained that the Himalaya, the northern Himalaya, separates India from the rest of the country and hence protect India from the bitterly cold and the dry winds of the Central Asia at the time of the winter, and at the time of the it also acts as a physical barrier for rain bearing southwest monsoon. So Himalaya has a important role in maintaining the temperature of our country. Now, if we talk about the seasons of India, even broadly, the seasons of India can be divided into four different parts. So we will try to identify the role of each parts, each factor we will understand in a deep manner. Let's move. So if we talk about the winter, in the winter season, the temperature of India remains from 5 degrees centigrade to 10 to 15 degrees centigrade in the whole country. mainly clear sky happens at the time of the winter. At the time of the winter, the sky is clear, but only one important event happens at the time of the winter season. That is called the western disturbances. Now, what is the meaning of the western disturbance? The western disturbance is mainly a depression, a low level depression that emerges at the time at the Mediterranean Sea. It is a low level depression which originates near the Mediterranean Sea, and it crosses Iran, Iraq, Afghanistan, Pakistan, and it enters into India, and it causes huge rainfall over the Indo-Gangetic Plain. Over the Indo-Gangetic Plain, the huge rain comes because of the western disturbance, but it has the positive role in the agriculture of India, because of the western disturbances, the rabi crop, it is beneficial for the cultivation of the rabi crop, that means wheat and barley. Because of the role of the western disturbance, it is beneficial for the cultivation of the rabi crop, which means the wheat and barley. So western cyclonic disturbance is a weather phenomena of the winter months brought by westerly flow of the Mediterranean Sea. It is mainly a depression, a low level, a low pressure created at the western part of the Mediterranean Sea, and it enters India through Iran, Iraq, the Pakistan, Afghanistan, and enters India, and it mainly causes rainfall in the Indo-Gangetic Plain. So it is beneficial for the crop of the wheat and barley. So it frequently comes in the exam. What is western disturbance? What is the role of altitude in the climate of India? What is the role of the Himalaya in determining the climate of India? This question comes. So you should be prepared. You already know the answer now. Next one is the hot weather season. That means the summer season. The summer season, the temperature remains around 47 degree in some places of the Rajasthan. 47 degree centigrade in some places of Rajasthan. In the Delhi also, the temperature go around the 45 degree centigrade during the time of the summer season. So the temperature goes very high, and the low pressure generates over the northern area of India, and it is the source of attraction for the southwest monsoon. The low pressure generates over the northern India. Here the important phenomena is the lu. It is a strong gusty hot dry winds blowing out during the day over the north and the northwestern India. So lu is the important feature of the summer season, and the temperature rises because of the rise of the temperature over the northern India. The air pressure also falls, and it becomes a cause of attraction for the southwest monsoon towards India. It is also called the Kal Baisakhi. Before the arrival of the monsoon, thunderstorm happen, and it also the although the rainfall may be small, but the thunderstorm is huge. It is called in West Bengal, it is called the Kal Baisakhi. And in the southern India of Kerala and Karnataka, it is called the mango shower. Mango shower, why it is called mango shower? Because it is ideal for the ripening of the mango, and it brings this phenomena brings sweetness in the mango. So it is called the mango shower in the South India of Kerala and the Karnataka. Let's move. Next one is the Thar Desert. So what is the role of the Thar Desert into India? Let's understand the role of the Thar Desert. If you talk about the Thar Desert of Rajasthan, the temperature remains around 47 to 50 degrees centigrade at the daytime. In the time of the winter is sorry in the time of the summer season, and in this area the Tibetan Plateau is located. Tibetan Plateau. So in the Tibetan Plateau also it is a source of heat because of the heat over the Tibetan Plateau and the Thar Desert. It is a source of attraction for the southwestern monsoon to enter into India. It also creates a low pressure over these areas, and because of these low pressures, the higher will be the low pressure, the more faster the southwestern monsoon will come. The first sign of the southwestern monsoon is in the Kerala. On the 1st June, the southwest monsoon knocks Kerala. It reaches Kerala coast at the 1st June. It may be 2 or 3 day delay, but around 1st June, the monsoon enters Kerala and it causes rain. That is called the arrival of the southwest monsoon. So the higher will be the temperature, the more low pressure area will generate over there, and it will affect the jet streams. So what is the jet stream? We will study now the jet streams. It will affect the jet streams, and the stronger the temperature will and the stronger the monsoon will come. So let's go to our point. Thar Desert. The Thar Desert plays a crucial role in attracting the moisture-laden southwestern monsoon wind that comes between June to October and provide majority of India's rainfall. Tibetan Plateau. Just now I have explained that during the summer season, the vertical air currents results in the vertical air currents and the formation of high pressure over the plateau about 9 km above the sea level. If we talk about the Tibetan Plateau, it is called the largest plateau in the world. The largest plateau in the world. Another plateau is called the Pamir Knot, which is called the roof of the world. The Pamir Knot is called the roof of world. The roof of the world is called the Pamir Knot, the Pamir Plateau. So the height remains around 4,800 meters, and it is called the Tibetan Plateau. I hope that you are able to understand this. So let's move. Another one is the jet stream. So the jet stream. So if we talk about the jet streams, the jet streams are those faster winds which flow on the earth above 8 to 10 kilometer. The jet streams are the faster winds 8 to 10 kilometer above the land of the world, above the land. So the faster it is, more faster around it, the speed of the jet streams can be around 120 kilometer per hour, even more than that. We are not affected by the jet streams, but we don't experience, actually of course we are affected by the jet streams, but we don't experience the jet streams. The people who are associated with the aviation sectors and the pilots, they face the problem of the jet streams. These jet streams also decide the monsoon. The more faster will be the jet streams, the more faster the monsoon will come. So the western cyclonic disturbance experienced in the north and northwestern part of the country are brought about by the western flow. So the jet streams are the speedy winds which flows around 8 to 10 kilometer above the sea level, and the faster will be the low pressure area, the faster will be the low pressure area, the faster will be the jet streams, and the more faster the monsoon will come. So if you talk about the arrival of the monsoon, it reaches the Kerala coast by 1st June. By 5th June, it also comes, and by 10th June it comes to Mumbai, and it causes rainfall all over the India. So next one, so this is the so the jet stream is also called the upper air circulation. Upper air circulation is another name of the jet streams only. So the summer monsoon, if we talk about the Arabian Sea, mainly our India is called the peninsular India, which is divided by the Arabian Sea to the western part and the Bay of Bengal to the eastern part. But the cyclone originate at the Bay of Bengal, which affect the seashore areas, the states which are associated with the seashore. And the southwestern monsoon comes, and the stronger monsoon we get from the Arabian Sea. Most of the rainfall happens because of the monsoon of the Arabian Sea. The Bay of Bengal is mainly famous for the cyclone. Majority of the cyclone originate at the Bay of Bengal and causes the rainfall over India. So let's move. Advancing monsoon or the rainy season. By early June, the rainy season starts into India, and because of the low pressure area over the mainland India, it attracts the trade winds or the southeastern or the southwestern winds, and they crosses the equator and brings heavy rainfall over India. Now, what is the meaning of the rain shadow area? Here, the Deccan Plateau and the parts of Madhya Pradesh becomes the rain shadow area. Here you should understand that at the time of the orographic rainfall, in the course of the movement of the monsoon, if any mountain comes, then the cloud has to go up, and it brings rainfall when it ascends the mountain. So it brings the rainfall, and the another part of the mountain is called the rain shadow area. Rain shadow, here the rainfall don't happen. Rain shadow area, in the rain shadow area the rainfall don't happen, and in this side, in the another side, that is the leeward side, the rainfall happens. And in the rain shadow area, the rainfall don't happen, but the rainfall happen at the time of the retreating monsoon, which we are going to understand just. So the monsoon run here, the majority of the rainfall happens in the northwestern part of the country. That means the seven sister states. The rainfall happens at the maximum speed. It is also called the seven sister state. It means the Tripura, Mizoram, Manipur, Meghalaya. Even the Monsoon Ram is the place which has the highest average of the rainfall. It is above 200 centimeter. The above 200 centimeter, the rainfall happens in the Monsoon Ram. Now let's talk about the retreating monsoon. The retreating monsoon means going back. Whenever the monsoon is going back after the generation of the high pressure area, after the rainfall happens in the northern area, in the northern India, the high pressure generates because of the rainfall. The high pressure areas. And another one, I am telling, because of the presence of the Himalaya, it do not allow the monsoon to go towards the Tibetan plateau, and it has to turn back because of the high pressure area generated over the northern India. And on the back, on the retreating monsoon, when the retreating monsoon is going back towards the equator or from India, it causes rainfall in the Tamil Nadu and the Kerala. So during the Tamil Nadu and the Kerala, again at the time of the retreating monsoon, the rainfall happens. So it is called the retreating monsoon. The retreating monsoon means going back towards the southern India. So this phase is the monsoon is so this phase of monsoon is also called the retreating monsoon. Retreating means the going back. Finally, El Nino and the La Nina. El Nino and the La Nina is the occurrence at the coast of the Peru. Peru is a country. So at the coast of the Peru, because of the differences of the temperature, El Nino and the La Nina affects the climate of our country. It is also called the remote causes, because some causes are closer to India, some causes which affect the Indian climate are very close, and some causes are remote. So El Nino and the La Nina is the remote cause which affect the climate of India. El Nino brings drought into India. And the La Nina, it is the harbinger of heavy rain. If the El Nino comes, it will bring less rainfall than the average in India. And whenever the La Nina will come, it will bring heavy rainfall over India. So it also affects the climate of our India. You can write down what is the meaning of El Nino and the La Nina. So thank you. I hope that I am able to make you understand about all the factors which affect the climate of India, in which we have discussed every factor in a detailed manner. I hope that you are able to understand each factor. So thank you for watching the video. Thank you. Thank you for being with us and watching the video. This is my email ID. If you want to ask any question, you can directly contact me on this email ID. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel for more and more updates. Thank you.